Good day friends, I am Dr. S.K. Gupta and I am going to talk to you about the grading of hydronephrosis. Grading of hydronephrosis has been done by Society of Fetal Medicine into grade 1, grade 2 and grade 3 and grade 4. Some people divide it into mild, moderate and severe. We are going to see some cases and see whether we are dealing with mild hydronephrosis, moderate or severe one. As you can all see, this is a kidney where you can see mild hydronephrosis. It is mild hydronephrosis because the renal pelvis is dilated. Renal calluses are not dilated, they are opposed to each other and the cortical thickness is well maintained. These cases are called as the grade 1 or mild hydronephrosis. This is a patient in which you can see that the renal pelvis is dilated a bit but the calluses have opened up. And this is mild hydronephrosis grade 2, and here you find that the shape of the renal calluseal system is well maintained, the renal cortical thickness is well maintained, and this is called as a grade 2 or mild hydronephrosis grade 2. This is moderate to severe hydronephrosis of the renal pelvic calluseal system. You can see that the renal pelvis is dilated and so are the calluses. There is blunting of the fornices and there is flattening of the papilla and the cortical thickness is mildly decreased. We are going to show you a case, another case of very severe hydronephrosis. This is the another kidney of the same patient and you can see that there is much more severe hydronephrosis, and this is the renal cortex which is very highly thinned out. There is ballooning of the renal calluses and the renal pelvis is grossly dilated, and there is merging of the renal pelvis with the ballooned out renal calluses, and this is called the grade 4 or severe hydronephrosis. There has been a lot of criticism of the grading done by the Fetal Society of Medicine because these grading systems at times they merge with each other and one may not be able to differentiate the severe grade from the moderately severe grade, and there is lot of inter-observer variation, meaning thereby that when two observers they are given to grade the same patient, they would grade it differently. And also there is intra-observer variation, that if the same observer is given the same patient at two different occasions, he might grade the hydronephrosis into a different variety on two different times. Some people would label this patient into mild hydronephrosis while some will label it into severe hydronephrosis. Whenever you find the hydronephrosis in the kidney, you should try to put in the color and try to outline the renal vasculature, because the disturbed renal vasculature, decreased supply to the kidney signifies that the kidney's function is poor. Also, the radiologist or the sonologist should try to look for the flow of the urine from the ureter into the bladder, and if the bladder is filling well and there both the ureteric jets can be seen, it means that both the kidneys are functioning well and patient can be reassured. But if there is cortical thinning, then the patient needs to be careful and the hydronephrosis to be relieved by removing the causative pathology. Sometimes it may be very difficult to differentiate the polycystic kidney, as in this case, from the severe hydronephrosis, because in the severe hydronephrosis there is ballooning of the calluses, and in such cases one should look for the renal pelvis. In case the renal pelvis is not visualized in the kidney and the kidney is enlarged with the ballooning of the various cysts, then it is likely to be a case of polycystic kidney. But if the renal pelvis is well visualized and the ballooned out calluses, they appear to be communicating with the renal pelvis, then it is likely to be a case of severe hydronephrosis. I hope with this video you have been able to understand the grades of hydronephrosis. You will be able to apply them into the clinical practice. In case you like our video, please subscribe to our channel. Do not forget to press the like button. Share the video among your friends so that large number of people can be benefited. Thank you very much.